If you need to create conditional formatting, but what happens depends on another sheet. So for example, here on sheet two, I've got, is this a valid email address? Yes, no. If that says yes, then that will stay like that. But if it says no, I need it to black out. So it's fairly simple. We're going to highlight it. We're going to go home, conditional formatting. Now what's important here is this is going to be a new rule. And we need to use a formula to do it. And then all it says is what is the formula? And all we need to do is we go click here. I'm going to click on there. Now just notice there are dollar signs on both, important for just now. And I'm going to say, is it equal to no? If it is, then I'm going to just black it out. And I say, okay. So at the moment it says yes. If for whatever reason that says no, you'll see it blacks out. Now, similarly, we've got a whole bunch of items here. And on this sheet, we've got yeses and nos. Do we want to highlight it or not? So just to show you again, I'm going to highlight that. Conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula. And I'm going to go to this sheet. Now, important, note the highlighted cell is here. Even though the rest are highlighted, this is the active one. So I need to remember that. And I'm only going to click on that one there. Just notice again, there are dollar signs. And that's going to cause us a problem because I need, as it moves down, so row 13, must look at row 13, 14 at 14. So I'm just going to use F4. And just remove the dollar signs. I'm going to say if it's equal to, in inverted commas, yes. And I'm going to format it and maybe make it bright yellow. When I say okay. And what you'll see now is depending on whether there's a yes, no here, this highlights. So you'll see item three is currently no. Let's change it to yes. And you'll see it's highlighted.